Hello guys, once again it's Matt and today we have another video. Thank you all the members, all the patrons, make sure to subscribe and let's get into it guys. And as you know, we are having the winter sales or whatever it's called, the Christmas sales or whatever. The store has not yet come, the discounts on the store, but the GE discounts are here. So I decided to make two videos, one talking about my top 5 choices that I would buy for GE premiums right now since they are half price in tanks and then air. So this one is for tanks and then the next one will be for air, okay guys? So let's start. It's my personal opinion guys, for vehicles that I find it fun and enjoyable and that are actually good for grinding with my experiences and my friends' experiences having some of these, okay? So the fifth one is actually an interesting one, the AMX 30. So the AMX guys is kind of interesting because we do have the VBCI2 in that tech tree, right? That is a lot more expensive, but it is a lot higher in BR, and that's the problem that I have with that vehicle. It's a very specific vehicle, you know, in a way that you actually play with it. It doesn't have ATGMs, so you have to rely on your 30mm PFS DSs. Of course, you can penetrate a lot, but it is a very big vehicle and very lightly armored, and you don't have a proper main cannon like the other tanks. And the AMX, even though, yes, it is a lot lower in the BR and stuff, it's still a lot cheaper as well, 3,740 Golden Eagles. And although it doesn't have a stabilizer, it is a very good, you know, immobility tank. And also the ammunition, although it is only heat, it can do a lot of damage and it has a proper you know, rangefinder. Even though it's not laser, it can use the rangefinder to actually hit targets fairly well. So I think it's a very good tank. There's a friend of mine that actually researched the whole French tech tree with it, and I know it's very competitive if you know what you're doing. Don't expect, you know, the most armor in a tank. It is like a leopard, you would need to use it kinda. It's not really that, but those tanks that don't have really any like proper armor, like I don't know, a T64 or I don't know, something along those lines, but it's still a very very good tank and it can do a lot of damage with its heat round. The fourth one is the TO-55, a Russian tank. This tank is a little bit boring, I must say, for the person that is expecting something unique. It is unique, but, you know, it's complicated. There is two, actually, that I would like to say about the Russians. We have the 2S-38 and then the TO-55. The 2S-38 is also an amazing tank, but it is more player-specific as well. Although it has a very good gun that can penetrate a lot, it is still very lightly armored and a very high BR for the tank that it is, right? So you do need to be careful. If you are an experienced player, I would take the 2S-38, but if you are new to the game and you want to get a more reliable tank that can actually get you in the top ranks a little bit quicker, the TO-55 is a little bit easier to use. The only problem that I see with the TO-55 is that it's quite expensive compared to the 2S-38, but at the same time I think the effectiveness that you can have on it if you are a new player is much much better. You know, it's an MBT or a medium tank, if you will, more of a medium tank than an MBT, but still, so it's a lot easier to use, I think, for the average player, okay? The 2S-38 can be very OP if you know what you're doing, but it can be killed very easily as well. So yeah, I think it's divided between the two. I would buy the 2S-38 if you are a more experienced player, but if you're not, get the TO-55. Then for the third one, we have the OF-40 MTCA. Very similar to something like the Leopard. Very fast tank in general, right? I mean, it's not the fastest thing ever, but it is quite mobile. It doesn't have a lot of armor, but it is not as high as of a BR as other tanks. And it does have an APFSDS that can penetrate very well at its BR of 9.0, right? It's a tank that I think it's very competitive if it's used correctly, and it does have a laser rangefinder, which always helps as well. So although it doesn't have any armor, proper armor, it is a tank that it's very easy to use, and you know, it has a very good gun, so it's just a very standard tank for you to actually research, and I think it's worth it to actually take a look if you are trying to research Italy. I wouldn't advise you guys to research Italy, but if you are going for it, maybe consider the OF right now, because it's pretty cheap. It's 4,365, sorry. And then with the second one, the Khalid. The Khalid is an interesting one, guys, because I think it's a very, very good tank for the price, comparing to other things that you have in that tech tree. So you have the Vijayanta, but that thing, I gotta be honest, guys, even though yes, it can be competitive, it is just kind of a, you know, I'm not gonna say a light tank. It's not a light tank. It does have armor, but the armor on the Khalid is much better, and the gun on the Khalid is much better. So for the difference in price that you see there, even though you have a very hefty increase in price in BR, you still can shoot the L23, which is an amazing round for 9.3, and it's just a very good tank. Does the armor take everything? No, it's a chieftain, right? So it's a British tank, right? So the hull, it can be weirdly penetrated in certain angles, especially the lower glacis, of course, but in the upper glacis and in the turret, it can take a punch depending on what is shooting at you. It's not the most reliable armor ever, but it can take a punch. But the main thing is that you have a decent mobility, not really that fast, it really isn't fast, but you have an amazing gun for that BR. So that's where I think the Khalid just sells more, you know. And the last one, I would say that it's kind of a standard tank as well. The Swedish, or rather I say the Norwegian, I think it is, Leopard 1A5NO. Man, it's the same price as the other tanks, around the same price, 4,455 right now with the 50% discount. And guys, it's a Leopard 1A5. It's a very good tank. It has DM33s, right? 400 millimeters of penetration. Do you realize how good this thing is? I mean, it's the same BR as the Khalid, having a 105, so it will be loaded quicker. Of course, it has less armor than that, but it is a lot faster as well. And it has a 105, so it's a lot easier to reload, as I was saying, with the same penetration, basically. So it is an amazing tank. It is a tank that I really, really enjoy playing. And yeah, it's just very, very, very competitive if you know what you're doing. Does it mean that it can't take a punch or anything like that? No, it's still very easily destroyed. You know, it's a Leopard 1, there's nothing that can go around that fact that you can just get one shot at. But that's the thing, you are trading that for a very mobile tank. Don't get me wrong, it is a large tank, it is very easy to shoot at, so be careful, but it is a tank that in the right hands can destroy whole teams if you are very careful with your positioning, right? And that's where I think this tank is made to actually be used, right? It's supposed to just surprise attack everybody in theory, right? So very, very good tank, one of the best for the price. I gotta say, for all the tanks that I told you guys about, this one is for me the best, and I would definitely buy it if you are, you know, searching for a premium that is in discount right now to buy. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe and leave in the comments other things that you would actually buy with the GE discount. I see you guys on the next one. Make sure to subscribe and bye. See ya.